Hey guys, Nightos Commander here, and you're watching episode 42 of Pokemon Battle Zone. I actually have 3 battles in today's video, something a little bit different for you guys, so let's get straight into them. They lead off with a Sharpedo, I've got my good old Weavile, and this part's really cool, so Mega Sharpedo's like, "Whoa, look at me, I'm gonna Mega Evolve, look at me now, I am so much more powerful than you." And Weavile's like, "Meh, low kick," and KOs that thing in one hit. So, that was pretty anticlimactic for my opponent, just Mega Evolve, but it doesn't really matter because I carry the low kick. Yeah, that's it. So in comes the Metagross, but I really don't want to take a bullet punch straight to the face, so I bring in my Latios, but he turns out to go for the Meteor Mash. So yeah, I was actually expecting the bullet punch, since technically speaking, Metagross is slower than Weavile, so yeah, that's a thing. But I'm going to go straight in for the Thunderbolt, but it's not going to do that much damage in the long run. So I end up needing to fodder my Latios with the useless critical hit that came about from that. And now I'm just going to go ahead and lose my Latios in the process. So I bring in my Weavile now, and that's going to be pretty helpful because I'm actually Choice Banded, but I can just go straight in for the knockoff and KO this thing without much difficulty. That was actually the other reason why I switched out. I could have gone straight for the low kick right from the beginning, but I didn't think it would KO, so I switched out into my Latios. So in comes Reshiram, which is funny because that's a Pokemon that I use myself on my Omega Ruby file. That's pretty cool. But I'm going to go for knockoff, but it's definitely not going to KO that thing. So I'm going to take a Fusion Flare right head on, and so I'm going to lose my Weavile in the process. So, in comes my last Pokemon, which is Lucario. This is, of course, my Mega Lucario. I can go straight ahead and use Dragon Pulse, which probably will KO this thing because, well, it is Mega Lucario and it is super effective. So, I seriously can't see even a Reshiram taking this, especially with what little health it actually does have remaining. So, there goes the Reshiram and there goes the battle. So, I finally do win with my Omega Ruby file. That's pretty cool. So second battle now, I'm going to lead off with my Cobalion, because Cobalion's awesome. It's one of my favorite Pokemon from the previous generation. So they've got an Aggron, which is going to immediately Mega Evolve into Mega Aggron, which is actually going to prove to be quite a challenge for my Cobalion. So I'm going to go ahead and use Close Combat, but it's really not going to do that much, because in case you haven't noticed, Mega Aggron has really high defenses, and it also carries the Thunder Wave, which is going to be an absolute pain in the rear end for me. And obviously his strategy is to go ahead and use Iron Head, since that combos well with the Power Hacks, but I actually do take the critical hit, but I do actually survive through it, and end up going for another close combat, and I've actually dealt a lot of damage to that thing. Truly a testament to how strong in attack Cobalion actually does. So he goes ahead and uses Stealth Rock this turn for some reason, probably because he knew that if I did break through it, which I did, he was gonna die anyway. So he used the turn just to go ahead and use the Stealth Rocks to get more support. So that was actually pretty cool on Cobalion's part, because he broke through the flinching and the confusion all in one round. So that's pretty cool. So he brings in Sceptile, but oh my goodness, despite the fact that I've used Close Combat twice, I'm still able to take an Energy Ball from that thing. But unfortunately, the Close Combat wasn't enough to KO Sceptile, so I'm definitely going to lose my Cobalion this turn. But hey, valiant effort. Very valiant effort on your part, Cobalion. That was pretty awesome. So I'm going to bring in my Mega Alakazam now. I need not fear the Stealth Rocks because, well, let's face it, you know, I haven't got the Focus Sash for obvious reasons, so I can just Mega Evolve straight into Mega Alakazam. So I'm going to go ahead and use Trace. Yeah. Well, it's not completely worthless since I do carry the Energy Ball, but chances are I'm not going to take a hit anyway because, well, Mega Alakazam dies to pretty much any hit, even as a Mega Pokemon, so it doesn't really matter. But the last Pokemon's Greninja, which I'm completely fine with because I do outspeed, and now I can just go ahead and use Energy Ball and get rid of that thing in a heartbeat. Still not convinced that thing is Uber, you know. So here's the final battle in the video, and they go to lead off with a shiny Charizard. I'm going to assume that's probably the event Shiny Charizard that was recently distributed. So I'm going to lead off with my Weavile, and he's going to Mega Evolve right away into Mega Charizard Y, which is my favourite version of the two, although I do prefer the Shiny form to the X variant more than this variant. So that's a thing. So in comes the Draws, which is going to result in Sunlight, but I could just go straight in for the knockoff, but it's not enough to KO, which means I'm going to be eating a Flamethrower right to the face, and that's going to result in Weavile tasting a lot of hot spicy curry for the evening, because that's just how hot the Flamethrower from Charizard truly is. So, I'm going to go ahead and use Psychic, which definitely is going to get rid of this thing. Unfortunately, Mega Charizard really isn't the fastest thing in the metagame. The only workaround for it is it does get Dragon Dance, but the Y variant is better suited to special attacking because it gets a special boost as opposed to a physical boost with the other variant. So I'm going to go ahead and use Psychic on the Chandelure, but it's not going to KO, but I'm going to take his attack as well in the process, which is pretty cool. So he actually does survive the Psychic again, and now I'm going to lose my Latios to his Shadow Ball, so meh. Not really that bothered in the long run, because I could just bring in my Lucario and KO with it whatever's left. Since I know he's not Choice Scarfed, I need not fear that, since my Latios outsped it. So, that's pretty cool for me. Actually, my Latios is also Choice Scarfed, but it doesn't matter because I know he's not Choice Scarfed anyway, because I'm going to outspeed him. So, that gets rid of the Chandelure. So, the last Pokemon he's got, well, which we'll see in a minute once the sunlight vanishes, which is Hydreigon, which sucks for him because I'm a Mega Lucario, I carry the Aura Sphere, there's no way this thing is going to survive an Aura Sphere, and that's just going to one-shot this thing in an instant. So, that's the end of the three battles. I do hope you enjoyed. If you enjoy seeing three battles in a row, then let me know in the comments down below, and I'll certainly consider doing it more often if you guys like that. So, I will see you guys next time, and thanks so much for watching.